Welcome back, Nelbies. Let's jump right into it. Best, but you're the worst. What the hell was we thinking? Compromise for no reason. Cause we ain't got shit in common. But why you gotta fight for nothing? What the hell was we thinking? Dirty tears and I'm sinking. Since we're jumping right into it, I'm just going to go ahead and put some base coat on these nails so we can jump into some fun nail art for today. I do have something a little bit different set up for you guys today. We're going to be mostly focusing on the nail art portion of these nails. So, like I always say, let's jump right into it. Cause we ain't got shit in common. No, we ain't got shit in common. No conversation. So the first thing you're going to see me draw, I want to say, is the triangle part of it. And one thing I learned from the TikTok girlies and the girlies on Instagram is that art can be broken down into shapes. So when you're drawing something, you might draw triangles, circles, shapes in order to form the picture that you're trying to create. So that's one thing that I took away from that. But I'm doing some semi-simple art or nail art. So let's just. That's a little bit different from a lot of my videos is that I left a lot of my mistakes in the videos just to show that, you know, when you're doing nail art, it isn't going to always be perfect and you are going to have to clean things up or shape things up. So even with the hat, you're going to see me go in at the tip of the hat
and clean it up to where it's more of a clean triangle, even though it's going to be leaning to the side, because I wanted the effect that the hat wasn't straight up pointy, that it kind of like folded on the top of it. Like, if you know which hat costumes, sometimes the top can like fold over if they had the hat for a long time, quote unquote. But anyways, it was just a detail that I wanted. So I just cleaned up the top of the hat to make it more of the triangle shape at the top, but still kind of like have a lean to it. So once I was in love with it, I went ahead and cured it. Now I'm just going to go in each of these items, if you notice that I'm drawing, is going to be related to like Halloween or witchy vibes. Because this collection of colors that I'm using is called the House of Mystery. And I am going to link the video of me unboxing the colors so that way you guys can hear about these beautiful colors and understand the meaning of these colors, because they are well thought out. So I am going to link it so you guys can see the colors, but each one of the things that I'm drawing is based off of the fact that this type of collection. Of course, once I was done doing all the nail art, I kind of realized like some details that I could have added as far as like putting some logs on fire under the cordage. That's how you say it. Anyways, the point is, or just adding more details to the hat. Like I could have put a spider web under the hat. I was just noticing stuff that I could have added in as far as some like little details, but I'm really kind of new to like the whole drawing art portion on nails. So like when I have something in mind, I'm just trying to keep that in mind, draw that and kind of like get it over with. But I'm still learning to like stack things, I guess you could say. Like once I got to like the pinky, I was like, oh, I could put two of these on there. Y'all, like I said, I'm still in the new part of doing nail art on nails. So the main focal point colors that I'm using is from the House of Mystery by Madame Glam, but I'm also using a couple of their other gel items, like their black gel polish, their white gel polish, and their chrome gels. I have videos to review all those on my YouTube. Now that I've drawn them out, I'm just going in and adding the color to make it pop. So like the gold and the burgundy that I'm about to go in with. So basically, how I learned how to do this was like basically reverse how you would draw. So of course you want to do the outline first because that is going to be the staple point of what you're drawing, but the color helps. So for instance, I had to put the gold on first for the belt of the hat to be gold. And then behind that, for the hat to be burgundy, I had to paint it. Now, in reverse, like if I was drawing this nail art on top of the nail, I would go in with the burgundy color, then go in with the gold to make the buckle. But when you're doing the reverse, when you want it under the nails, you have to think about how you're going to see it under the nail and how you have to paint it out. So that is one detail that I didn't want to touch point on, is that the reason why I'm putting the color kind of like all over the hat on this part is because when you flip it over, it's going to look exactly like it's supposed to. So, like I said, there's going to be two main colors on each nail, and this one was the burgundy and a glitter color. You're going to see me paint the whole nail a glitter color because I wanted that background to be the focal point for the glitter because of how it looks.
Boy.
I'm not angry anymore, just a little bit.
I'm not angry anymore, just a little bit let down. So for the Witch's Brew Pie, I went in with the two grains, Nova and Vibrancy, because I wanted to look like it was some kind of potion or poison in the pot. So I also used Nova as the shiny part of the pot. You'll see what I'm talking about. Hold on. I'm not angry anymore, just a little upset now. I'm just a little upset now. So wanna be better than I was before, but I can't do it if you don't much. You're not angry anymore, just a little bit let down, a little bit let down, let down. So this one was actually a little fun and a little difficult. I did leave my mess up on here because, like I said, I just kind of wanted to show you guys. If I mess up, I do go in and fix it. It's not just always I get it on the first try. Like I said, everything is shapes. So you're going to see me draw shapes in order to create this nail art. So let's just watch. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You got those pretty eyes in your head. You know it. You got me dancing in my bed, so let me show it. You are exactly what I want. Kinda cool and kinda not. Wanna give myself to you. Yeah, we're driving down the freeway at night. I only got one thing in the back of my mind. I'm feeling like this might be my time to shine with you, with you, with you. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my picked the skull with the bones crossing. I mean, if you know anything about Halloween, that's definitely a staple. But also because, you know, witches' potions are, like, deadly. So, that is also why it's by the witch's brew pot. Y'all, I know it's called a cauldron or something like that, but don't hold me to it. And you guys, these last two nail arts, I was messing up so bad because, like, when you're drawing something on paper, your hand moves different than when you're painting something. And especially when you're painting something on a small surface. So when I went back, I used a tool to kind of help me out with, like, the first portion of the bones to kind of, like, tie it in all together. So I went in with a dotting tool and it helped very much to me trying to draw the M and then fill it in. So that's a key point that I did learn while doing this, is that the dotting tool is really good for the bone part of this nail art.
this is when it started to get fun for me as I just started moving along through the art. And it was kind of like a bell went off in my head and was like, oh, you could put more than one picture on the nail or whatever the case may be. And I was like, oh, I can add two pumpkins. And I actually love the way the pumpkins came out. The little swirly thing gave me a run for my money. But I pulled out a piece of paper, I drew it on there like I usually draw it, and then it helped me kind of like transfer that onto the nails. So that's what you're going to see me do when I'm starting to draw this squiggly part.
Thank you. tell me why. Why you gotta lie? Every time you lie, don't even wanna try. Baby, tell me why. Why you gotta lie to me? Baby, it's our time. All we do is fight. Maybe we should call it. I'm just being honest. Baby, it's our time. All we do is fight. Maybe we should call it what it is. Really thought you'd change my mind. Really thought you'd change.
Like it's not going to cover it, but it is. Trust the process. After that, I am going to go in with some top nail art, so stick around. Let's see. One thing I've learned about acrylic from working with it is that it works with you. It wants to work with you in gravity. So if you put your nail facing downwards, it'll move down the nail downward where you don't have to pull it so much. Also, I've learned if you lay it to your foundation, it'll keep that shape. So for instance, you don't have to go back in and do a lot of fouling because you're making sure your acrylic is going with your foundation. Acrylic literally follows gravity. So if you're holding your nail or the client's nail at like a straight shot, the acrylic is going to run off to the sides. That's why a lot of the times nail techs, we face the nail downward because acrylic works for gravity. So it's going to go down the nail instead of over into the side, spilling off of the sides and so forth. So as long as you're laying your acrylic to your foundation, you have nothing really to worry about. Another key point, when you're laying your cuticle bead, make it more dry than runny because you can pat it into place, but you don't want the acrylic to run into the back of the cuticles and flood the cuticles. So you want it more on the drier side than your regular beads. And then when you go in, you can do another very small bead on the more liquid side, then make it very small. So that way it's just sealing it, but you're not over flooding it. It's really tricky, but once you get it down with the cuticle bead, it'll be flawless. Yay! If you made it this far, I just want to say I appreciate you so much. If you have not liked and subscribed, please don't forget to subscribe and like the video before you head out. I just want to say thank you for making it this far. We're going to go ahead and jump into our nail art on top. And I got a little fun with it, so let's sit and watch. I'm going to try to do the bare minimum talking on this part, so let's go ahead and watch. I know I said bare minimum talking, but I just wanted to put this out there. The ice cream nail kind of just popped up in my head as I was doing the nail, because I was like, how can I make this fairy dust glitter work? And I was like, it kind of reminds me of melted ice cream with, you know, glitter sprinkles in it. So I was like, let me just go ahead and see what this looks like. And I absolutely loved it. It works so well for this purpose. And it is technically a top coat, so you don't have to go back in and actually top coat it. So Y'all, I really love the way this ice cream look came out.
Thank you. long day. I just wanna lay down and sleep on my bed, but you stuck in my head. I don't know why. Wish that you were next to me, 'cause it's been a long day. I just wanna lay down and sleep on my bed, but you stuck in my head. I don't know why. Wish that you were next to me. Next to me, next to me, you keep testing me, testing me. I knew that we were meant to be, the connection was mentally, but I wanted you physically. Basically, I'm trying to say is that your body is heavenly, chemically inducing me with ecstasy. Your smile in your eyes, I could go endlessly. Angel in disguise, gotta treat her carefully. I despise all these guys that try to step to me. Just know in her eyes, I'm the recipe to her bakery. I need her and she need me. Nothing could change at the Fago to her blueberry. Nothing could top that if you want. You can see what true love looks like. It's easy as 1, 2, 3. Been a long day. I just wanna lay down and sleep on my bed, but you stuck in my head. I don't know why. Wish that you were next to me, 'cause it's been a long day. I just wanna lay down and sleep on my bed, but you stuck in my head. I don't know why. Wish that you were next to me. I wish I was with you. Like, can I convince you to come drop the Addy? I pull out like tissue. I don't want no preview. Yeah, give me the sequel. I murdered a kitty. No desert like eagle. Let me come show you what I'm about. Leave my kids dancing in your mouth. And if you're ready, I'm headed towards the south. Alphabet, we can hit it in the couch. Found a knob, have you dripping like a spout. Slurp it up like you Kelly in a drought. Switching routes, hit the gym, make you shout. But it's all in my head, why can't you just get out? Why I think about you now, I have no clue. Thinking about us in the clouds, drinking soju. You laugh at my jokes with a snort that is so you. There's more to your beauty, can I get to know you? Been a
long day. Everyone loves a good French, so that's why I decided to do a French on the lipstick nail. And if you notice, all the nails have different shape. We have ballerina, we have lipstick, and I have stiletto and taper square. All the nails, I wanted to do different shapes, just so that way you can see the difference in the styles of the nails and the nail art.
I just wanna lay down and sleep on my bed, but you stuck in my head. I don't know why. Wish that you were next to me, 'cause it's been a long day. I just wanna lay down and sleep on my bed, but you stuck in my head. I don't know why. Wish that you were next to me.
Just a slight life update. This weather change has been kicking my butt. My eyes are watering. My nose is just going. I sound probably so stuffy. So I want to say just thank you guys for just tuning in and listening to me right now. But like, this weather change is crazy, because it's like hot right now, but I know it's like cold. Like, it's just a lot. It's a lot, y'all.
你烦你 You find you funny love You got it crazy now
my unboxing for the House of Mystery, then you remember me saying Nova and Vibrancy looks so pretty to me, and I have like so many ideas, but this was one of the ideas. I don't know, it's something about the two greens that want me to do line work on top of the other green. So like the Vibrancy and Nova on top, oh my god, like just look at this, y'all, just look at this, wait, just look at this. Thank you. personally, you can never go wrong with the marble. Look how pretty this gray and this burgundy meshed really well in this marble. Y'all, I was like, what? This came out so prettier than what it looks like in my head. And I'm glad I went through with it because it's so pretty. So this nail art was like straight off the top of my head. I was like, what can I do with this orange and still tie in the glitter? So originally I was going to do some French tips, but I had already did a French tip. So I was like, let me just do some lines, but I already did line work. And I was like, let me try some half circles. And it came out so pretty to me because it kind of, in the most weirdest way, reminds me of a dead finger. But just, you know, it's Halloween, y'all. So work with your girl. So we are coming to the end. This is the final piece of the nail art portion. I just want to say thank you any and everyone who liked, comment, and subscribe. We are at 379 subscribers. We're almost at 380. I'm super excited. So thank you guys. Like, comment, subscribe. See you guys next time. You, 'cause I only want you. Yeah. 'Cause I only want you. Yeah. 'Cause I only want you.